Hi, hello, my name is Sang 820. I use the online translator to read the transcript. Hope this will help you better understand the video content. Last week, when chatting in WeChat group, a certain rising artist showed us his 3D animations. It's a deer running and jumping on complex terrain. Here are some interesting half-finished animations and I have some suggestions. For example, deer running uphill and running downhill should pay attention to the speed difference, and so on. He thinks it makes sense, but will not continue to scrutinize these details. In that case, I'll continue to work on these details myself, using Moho. I think people who like animation, especially Disney animation, will always be obsessed with deer running and jumping, First I need to draw the shape of a deer, then I found out. Damn, how do I know what a deer looks like? Actually don't know the details of the deer. Like everyone else, I vaguely think, dogs are deer without horns, deer are dogs with horns. I don't want to learn the musculoskeletal knowledge of deer from scratch, after all I'm just improvising. So I opened Baidu to search for pictures of deer, and found some photos and GIFs of the road. Look, beautiful creatures, beautiful waves, beautiful lines ... I don't know who the original author of this animation is, but I salute him. According to the shape of the animation, I made a simple Moho model. Set the keyframes according to the pose in the animation, and I get a loop running of a beautiful deer. I drew a scribbled topographic sketch. Mark the possible states of the deer passing through this terrain. Plan routes, preset states. But this is too vague, I need to know the specific rhythm and timing of these movements. I have to first animate a simple object, like a ball, through this terrain. Use this as a reference for the rhythm of the deer animation. Of course, I'm going to rebuild this terrain in Moho, then, bring the ball to life. First use the layer tool, to determine the position and rhythm of the movement of the ball. Then I used a function that I am not very familiar with, motion curve. I know this feature is important, but it's haven't used it much for animation, I know almost nothing about it, so I made a couple of mistakes next. I'm used to controlling the movement of objects with the interval and number of keyframes, like this. I want it to move faster, so I shorten the keyframe interval. I want it to be slower, just lengthen the interval of keyframes. If there is complex motion, I add keyframes. But if it goes further, I want rounded motion trails and weight distribution keyframes. I have to use the motion curve function. First create position keyframes at the beginning and end of the action. Select these keyframes, right-click and select Bezier curves. Click the motion curve tab. Double-click the layer movement icon to zoom in on the timeline. I can change the transition state between keyframes by adjusting the angle and length of the handle. Hold down the Alt key to adjust the handle unidirectionally. The three colored lines represent the X, Y, and Z axes of the layer movement. I didn't realize this at first and adjusted the Z axis blue line. But I actually only need the animation on the X and Y axes. Land, charge, big jump, small jump, exhaustion, adjust posture, step, big jump, stall fall, roll, stop. The character goes through this process. According to this idea, I add motion deformation to the ball. In fact, this step may not be needed, but maybe it's an occupational disease? Well, this is much more comfortable. I expanded the starting terrain so that the deer can stretch into the picture. I split the animation of the deer into three parts: A movement path, B movement rhythm, and C pose. A and B have been basically determined through sketch, ball. The sample of pose comes from the deer running and jumping that I originally copied. They contain most of the key patterns I need. I only need to create a few poses to complete the whole animation. More workload should be model matching pose, some purely technical issues. Yeah, that's what I thought at first. Oh, of course the actual situation is completely different, ... Okay, we're back to the Moho model of the deer. I think deer use their hind legs when they run and jump. Front leg assist and stabilize center of gravity. So I set the parent bone to the deer's hip, and use this as the origin to derive other movements. The part where the deer is drawn in the front can be applied with the adjusted running loop. We just need to make sure the deer lands and jumps in the same position. This is the easiest part. At frame 50, we're going to break the loop and switch to the deer jumping pose. Slowly transition to frame 65 where the deer is ready to land. The 66th frame switches to the pose of Lufu lowering his body, landing buffer, and preparing to jump. The fall potential is not very large, so I combine the buffering and preparation into one frame. Then the deer jumped forward and hit the dirt slope at frame 77 and slid down the bottom of the slope. You may have noticed that I adjusted the motion curve of the deer's hip bones. This makes the animation rhythm appear clearer and more tense. During the actual animation, I found that the movements of the deer and the ball do not completely coincide. They have different motion textures, but the animation of the balls is a good preview for the deer. On this basis, I can better express the movement characteristics of deer. We are now adjusting the pose at the bone level. More detailed animations are done later at the node level. Frame 205, the deer stalled and fell to the ground. I made a 4-frame buffer. A deer has a lot of joints. It's more like a long object. It's impossible to bounce off the ground like a ball. It first touches the shoulder and neck, and then the potential energy is transmitted to the waist and hip through the trunk. Disperse the falling potential energy to the ground by rolling the body. While it may seem exaggerated, it doesn't actually do much harm to it. This strategy is quite clever. The 218th frame deer released the potential energy of the fall and is about to get up. Existing bones prevent me from making perspective motions, so I ditched the bones and used node models entirely to animate the deer getting up. The rear leg, which is the driving force of the whole body, drives the front leg to stand up. Head off the ground at the end, and jump backwards to avoid danger. At the same time, shake your head to regain consciousness and stand firm. Look up at the slope where you fell. You can see me stretching the deer's face on purpose. It's funny, my bad taste. The animation is almost complete. I replayed this animation over and over, over and over. I always feel that this animation lacks vitality. Maybe the law of movement is not good enough, maybe the pose lacks fun. Maybe the conceptual terrain is too indifferent, maybe all of the above. But in the short term I can't improve the level of these abilities so I turn to trying to strengthen the connection between the deer and the terrain, not just a simple interaction. I need a more infectious medium to bond the deer and the soil slope. Make them a whole. As you can see, I chose snow. The environment is set to thick snow-covered snow-capped mountains. The snow is the virtual world's feedback on the deer's behavior. Without real feedback, there is no real action. The snow peeled off and collapsed, confirming that the deer had acted, proving that the deer really existed. Make this animation more real and vivid. Regarding the production method of snow, I use a more traditional method. Brain computational dynamics plus hand adjustment point keyframes. I'm not very familiar with Moho's physical dynamics feature. I think handmade is easier to control. 2D animation is a subjective expression, not an objective and correct expression. I made an animation of the snow falling apart for the deer getting up and shaking his head alone. This allows us to bring in real-world experience and make the fawn's behavior more believable. Regarding the background, my usual method is flat color plus node coloring plus gradient filter. In order to increase the dynamic of the background, I quoted a dynamic material of clouds and fog. Overlay on top of background layer. Deer, hillsides, and snow are placed in one layer as a mask. I love animation, but I have no professional animation training. I will only use some basic functions of Moho. But I believe that as long as you observe life carefully and love the details of life, you can create your favorite and interesting animations. Have a nice day.